Good evening, everybody. Welcome to your terrific Tuesday evening Turning Point Devo for Tuesday, September 21st, 2021, in episode 45. Today we're going to be talking about Chain of Grace, beginning with Acts 5, 42 from the NIV. Listen to this. Your recommended reading is Acts 5, 40 through 42. So I'll read my version and compare the two. Turning Point is from Woodrow Crawl today. And we have an excerpt from Susie Richardson, which will be about the third section, because they got the way they've got the words sectioned off in the paragraphs. And today's daily reading is Jonah, the book of Jonah. All four chapters of the book of Jonah. So, if you're excited, if you're ready to see what this one's going to have in store for you today, smash that like button. Leave a positive, encouraging comment or two or something that you would like to let me know about that I've done or said or something that you would like me to do. Long as it's a positive comment, I'll read it and respond back to it if it's feasible. But if you're new here, hit that subscribe button, hit that notification bell, share the video and the channel with your family and friends to help me get more subscribers, help me reach that goal of 1,000 subscribers, which I would love to hit. And I would love to make my subscriber number bigger. So if you would pass the word around about my channel and get me some more subscribers, I would appreciate it very much. So without further ado, let's see what Chain of Grace has in store for us. Acts 5:42 NIV. Day after day in the temple courts and from house to house, they never stopped teaching and proclaiming the good news that Jesus is the Messiah. Now, your recommended reading today is Acts 5, 40 through 42. So let me read you my version. And they agreed with him, and when they had called for the apostles and beaten them, they commanded that they should not speak in the name of Jesus and let them go. So they departed from the presence of the council, rejoicing that they were counted worthy to suffer shame for his name. And daily in the temple and in every house, they did not cease teaching and preaching Jesus as the Christ. So daily in the temple and every house, they did not cease teaching and preaching Jesus as the Christ. Sorry for covering the camera, but I was reading. And then this one says, day after day in the temple courts and from house to house, they never stopped teaching and proclaiming the good news that Jesus is the Messiah. Just a different way of saying that verse. But on the crew website, Susie Richardson tells a story of a troubled Boston youth named Nassif. N-A-S-E-E-F. Nassif. Who was being drawn into a game. And a school teacher told him, "You don't want to go down this path, Nassif. You can do better. God has a plan for you. Put him first." Nassif joined the wrestling team and tried to focus on academics. Getting through high school, he enrolled in Boston's Bentley University. That's where he met a crew intern named Andrew. C-R-U, crew. Who shared the gospel with him. "I prayed, but never read the Bible," Nassif recalls. "Now I realize why Jesus died on the cross, so I could be forgiven for what I did." Today, Nassif actively shares his faith with others. He says, "I explain to my friends how God is growing me, and that it happens in small steps, especially when you're in rough situations." And that was taken from the an excerpt from an article by Susie Richardson called Why Nassif Left His Game. December 9th, 2015 is when the article was done. Or the story, whatever. So the good news is the promise of salvation. When we have received Christ, we get to proclaim Him to others. That's the good news miracle that forges us into the links of the chain stretching from Pentecost to the second coming. So Woodrow Cross says today's turning point. He says that others report bad news, we'll share the good news. So let the others share the bad news, but we will share the good news. Amen? So that's all I have for your... Tomorrow's daily reading is the book of Micah, by the way. So I'm letting you know that. Go ahead and get that out of the way. The book of Micah. And I think it says four chapters. No, wait a minute. The book of Micah, chapters 1 through 4. Then we'll finish up the book of Micah on Thursday. We're just having 2 days in the book of Micah. So it's a little longer than other books. But coming up in your morning Devo tomorrow, for Wednesday, September 22nd, 2021, at episode 485, I believe. 85. We're going to be talking about being purified 7 times. So we're back into some regular Devos. Until Thursday, we'll be back in the, and then there's a regular, and then it's a God series, then a duh series, a duh video, we'll have 3 back-to-back duhs. Oh boy. But purified 7 times, beginning with Psalms 12, verses 6 and 7. So stay tuned for that. I'll get that. That'll be my next. That'll be the next video in my next run. I'm gonna stop with that one. So I usually try to do about 3 days at a time, because I have, usually if it was just the one doing the days of praise, usually I can get a whole week's done, because there would be 6-7 videos I could do a whole week. But now I have 2 videos, it's hard to do a whole week. So I do 3 days of praise, and then I'll do the 2 or 3. Now on the weekends, when I only have 1 on Saturday, I get to do an extra day. Like say if I tried to do Thursday, Friday, maybe Saturday and Sunday, and I only have to do the 1 on Saturday, 1 for Saturday. That means I'll get 6 and then have that 1 for Saturday. Because I have 2 the other days. But I'm going to try to do where I can do Sunday be the first one I start off with. Do Sunday, Monday, Tuesday. Then Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. And Saturday. I throw that in the last one. I do Sunday, Monday, Tuesday. Try to throw it up that way. Never works that way, but. So my next run, I'll do Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and then the Saturday videos. That way I'll do the 6 and then have the 7th one be a single. So. That's what we'll do the next time. So with that said, I love you. Appreciate you. Thanks for watching. Another video before 10 minutes. So maybe I'm on a roll. Maybe I don't know how to do it now. But keep on keeping on and trusting God, and He'll keep you safe in all you say and do. And until tomorrow, everybody, peace out. Goodbye. God bless. Have a wonderful rest of your terrific Tuesday evening. Come back again tomorrow for another glorious Wednesday. And I just went over 10 minutes. Oh, well. Oh, shucks. But see you then. Goodbye.